So I'm Peggy Wagner, and I work with the Greenville Health System, what we call the Health Sciences Center, and it's an affiliation of Clemson University, the University of South Carolina, Furman University, and GHS, Greenville Health System. And I currently am the director of what we call the Patient Engagement Studios, and I'm a professor emeritus from USC. The term studio is kind of interesting, because even our patients wonder why we call it a studio, because we don't have video cameras or any of that. But it's really a group of people sort of working together, and conceptually the studio is just our minds and sort of how we talk to each other, having conversations similar to this. And we don't have a permanent location in the health system, so we meet in different rooms in different places, and so the studio is just a group of researchers and patients and who are talking about projects. We recently received a small PCORI award to build diabetes studios, and we've chosen to do one in Greenville, which is a more urban setting, and one in Lawrence County, which is very rural, South Carolina. And so we've brought these two groups of patients together. We have 12 in Greenville and I believe 8 or 10 in Lawrence County. And we've spent 4 months doing what we call trust building. And we meet twice a month and really just sort of sharing stories and doing some activities that we think will encourage that, and really just getting to know them as people. And then we've moved into a research capacity building phase where we've done some more traditional training on what is the research question. So these studios are to take questions from that patients have and turn them into research questions, and then we will pitch them to researchers from those institutions that I mentioned earlier. I think it has changed how I conceptualize research as I recognize more. I think I've always included patients, but I was doing things to patients and gathering information from patients, but I wasn't including them in the process of designing the research, and so I think that's really changed.
My name is Ann Blair Kennedy, and I'm at the University of South Carolina School of Medicine, Greenville. So I'd always been really wanting to get stakeholders in, and then I start my postdoc, not in patient engagement, but Peggy found me, and just when the studio was starting, she invited me to come. And I went, oh, that would be really smart to ask patients what they would like and what would be important to them. So it really opened my eyes to something, and they have changed the way I look at research that I never expected to happen. The patients know a lot more than you think they do, for first, and they would know what they need. So listen, take the time to stop and listen, and they'll tell you their story.
My name is Kenneth Baxter, and I'm a native Greenvillian here. I'm on the Diabetes Engagement Studio, and I'm having lots of fun and learning a lot from the other patients and caregivers. We're a very diverse group. The group mixture is fantastic. We got male, female, different ethnic groups, different job titles. We got lawyers, we've got retired people, we've got mothers. It's just a very diverse group, and I knew from the beginning, when I came into that group and we start talking to each other, I knew from the beginning that this group was going to be so close that we're going to be like a little small family. And sure enough, about the third meeting, we were good. Well, we met with a researcher about 3 weeks ago to talk about how researchers should ask those questions and what questions we should ask the researchers. And I think when we told the researcher that, we're talking from our heart. We're talking from our experiences, and we're asking questions from our heritage, or either we're asking questions from friends that we've known that have diabetes, and we've seen things happen. So when we ask questions, those questions are coming from those experiences that we have.
My name is Deb Frederick, and I'm a member of the Diabetes Engagement Studio, and I found out about it through the Diabetes Education Program, and it's been a wonderful project to come into. Well, I love education, so I saw it as a chance to learn something myself. I'm an insulin-dependent diabetic. I thought that I might have something to offer because I am able to control my diabetes pretty well these days, and I wish other people could too, so I wanted to contribute in that way. And I'm also interested in research. I've not done tons of it myself. I've been involved a little bit, but I just thought my 2 cents worth might help there be better research in the future for diabetics. I think the researchers are going to see really how what they're doing impacts real people who live real lives, who are at different points in their particular disease, and what the practicalities are of everyday life. And when you, I sometimes think people involved in healthcare, for all the good intentions and all the wonderful information and skill, don't always understand what the day-to-day life is of someone who's been given a prescription or treatment plans that they have to follow, and we're able to provide that. This is how what you're telling us or what you're doing impacts our daily lives. And even if you don't ask us about it, we're going to tell you about it. You know, maybe there's questions researchers have never thought of because they're in a different role than patients, and we're able to from our own experience and intimate involvement in a particular disease process, be able to offer a little window for the research world.
My name is Melanie Cozad, and I'm an assistant professor at the University of South Carolina. I work with the Greenville Health System in order to do research within a living, moving health system. So mainly my projects focus on the creation of tools that measure patients' goals and priorities and thinking about how to implement those tools for use within clinical care. So obviously to tailor a tool to a patient's needs, we've been heavily involved with the development of patient engagement and the inclusion of patients as researchers in the process, because to tailor a tool to what patients need, you have to have the patient experience. I just did a lot of thinking where there were decision points in previous projects that I would make as a researcher, and I had always thought, well, it would be nice to have a second opinion. And generally, as a researcher, when you want to reach out and have a second opinion, you go to another researcher. But to me, it sort of made sense that if you operate under the premise that patients bring experiential knowledge with respect to their conditions, that they would be a wonderful second opinion. In talking and taking the results to patients, what I realized was patients with their experiential knowledge were able to tell me, well, yes, this is a really big thing, but maybe we should consolidate two of these things because there's an interaction there with how they work in my lifestyle. And so patients have brought a richer interpretation of the results because they have this experiential knowledge.
I am Nikki Ward, and I'm a patient expert. Our research panel is discussing diabetes, and we're particularly focusing on diabetes in a rural county like Lawrence County, where there's a lot of poverty and a very high incidence of diabetes. We've got a very diverse group of ages, of walks of life, but we all have fit together into a good group, and all seem to be able to come onto each other's wavelengths as we discuss things in each session. We just finished two different sessions with a researcher who helped us walk through the process of what you need to have in a good research question, and he helped us focus on what we would need to be sure that we include. I think we had all been worrying about our ideas not sounding intelligent enough to present to a bunch of researchers and scientists, and I think he did a really good job of making us feel more confident in how we would present that to them.
My name's Cole Brown, and I'm one of the patient experts with the Patient Engagement Studio.
For me, I really try to make that connection to my past experiences. For those family members that were a part of my past experiences, I feel like, you know, the difference that we can make as a studio really comes a lot, alive in those conversations. For those that may not know as much about my past medical, history, it's just exciting from the standpoint of bringing in different perspectives, and that we're looking at other people's perspectives and not just one person's. And so really, when I engage in those and talk about the opportunities that the groups are providing, I really look at it as, you know, how are we changing the healthcare industry and how do we have the opportunity to further that research that's going to be critical for us to be successful down the road. So whether they have a research background or not, I still feel like I'm getting that same point across that, you know, the work that we're doing is going to make a difference for somebody down the road. And no matter how big it is, to me, it's not about, you know, if it we're you know, changing everything or if we're just making one person's life a little better, that to me is impactful. When I hear the word patient expert, my first reaction is I'm finally looked at as a part of the care team. I'm a part of this process that we call research, healthcare, you know, innovation. And when I hear expert, I feel like, you know, when you go through something, you know, continuously, if you have a chronic condition like myself, you're going to, you know, you're going to become, you know, so, you know, attuned to it, and you're going to be able to provide a perspective that others cannot.
Johnny Payne, and I'm one of the patient experts. You need to be open-minded. You need to be willing to share. You need to feel part of the team, and you don't need to be intimidated by researchers and doctors who you think might know more about what's going on. They may know more about the disease itself, but they certainly don't know more about being a patient. And that's what we bring. And that's really all you need. But the attitude is important. You need to speak up. You can't be, I guess, intimidated, as I said before, and you certainly can't be shy. And you gotta be certain that what you have to share is important. And you have to feel like that they're going to listen to you. I'm so pleased that researchers are now beginning to come to patients, which years ago, this was never happened. I mean, we'd go in there and they would tell us everything we needed to know and without any consideration about what we had to offer. So now that we've got this opportunity, we need to embrace it. And that's another thing I tell other people in the community, that if they get a chance to serve as a patient expert. I'm a little uncomfortable using that word expert. I don't consider myself an expert, but I'm going to use it because that's what they're using it. But if you get a chance to serve as a patient expert, you should take advantage of it because you have so much to offer. And I think most patients don't realize what we have to offer. I'm just now learning that myself. I'm learning that what I have to offer was important. I just feel like that this is a The way the future research is going to be approached with patients involved, I think that now that we've become involved, I think that that's going to continue.